everybody, it is April here again with another tutorial in Cricut Design Space software. And today we're going to go over bringing in a printable image and how you can use the Design Space software to cut out directly around your image. It's almost like having a die cut for your digital image. So I'm going to click New Project. I'm in Design Space. You can click New Project here, or you can click New Project here. So I'm going to click New Project in the upper right-hand corner. My image is for a design team project, and it is not in Design Space yet, so I want to bring it into the Design Space software. So I'm going to click Upload, which is along the left-hand menu bar. And here it says upload. You can do upload image or upload pattern. Today I'm going to upload an image. And it tells you here which image types you can upload: PNG, JPEG, GIF, SVG, DXF, and BMP. So I am going to upload this ballerina, and I'm going to choose the JPEG. Now, you also have the opportunity here where Design Space will try and help you get the image cut where you want, and you have the option to choose simple, moderately complex, and complex. My image is just a black and white image, so I'm going to go with simple, and I'm going to click continue, and then I get a really big image, and I don't know how to resize it, which is fine. I think I may see how to resize it. I'm going to learn during this video too. And here we have select and erase. Click on the areas of the image you want to remove. Use advanced option below for additional controls. Now I am not sure what these will do for me, and I'll have to do some research and go over that in a future video. But what I want to do now is I want to click where my image is, and you can see that it has put a checkerboard behind my image. And what's going to happen is my cut line will run along that checkerboard. Now, if you notice here where I think it should be cut out, because I think the sky or the background would be open, and that's not really part of the image. So I can click here, and you see the checkerboard appear there. So then I should get a cutout there. Now when I go here and try and get a cutout here, that works fine. But if you notice, this image isn't quite connected here. The lines don't totally enclose. So when I click here, it fills all that in, and I don't want that. So I'm going to go to the upper right hand corner, and I'm going to click undo. And I could probably print this image out, fill those spaces in, get it to cut out, but I'm not going to go to all that trouble right now. So there I can click, because it's totally enclosed, I'm going to get the checkerboard behind it, and I can click there and get the checkerboard. If I come up here, if I want this little curly Q to be cut out, I can click there and there and there, and I will have those images with the cutout where her hair will be free. And I'm looking because sometimes I'll miss spots. And if I go here, this minus sign, see, I learn something every time, will zoom out. So I can get a better picture of what's going to be cut out and what's not going to be cut out. Now I do like zooming in, because then you get a close-up of what your image looks like. And you might find spots that you wouldn't necessarily see, like this little cutout, if you had the image smaller. So I am happy with, nope, I'm not happy with this. Here I've got, because see how that's open right there? And if we zoom in, you can see that more clearly. This image has a line that doesn't quite connect. So when we filled in the background, that caused this to be filled in as well. So what I can do, I'm going to kill me a cat. Not really, just kidding. But my cat is messing with me. So, sorry about that. What I can do is I can go to my erase tool, and this is a determination of how big my eraser is going to be, and I think this is a good size. And I was hoping I could erase that from being cut out. It doesn't look like that's going to happen. Let's see if I use the crop. Nope, that's not what I want to do. Okay, so it looks like I'm just going to have to live with that until I get a better idea of how I can fix that. All right, so I need to go back to my select and erase, and I'm going to get those little spots that I chose earlier before my cat. And I'm blaming her. I don't know if she really did it or not. Okay. All right. So here I can zoom out and get a better idea of where it's going to cut. So the more that your image has connected lines, the better this tool will work. So when you have hand-drawn images, it's going to be a little less reliable simply because it assumes that when you have an image where lines don't meet, that's open space. So I have clicked all the spaces that I want to be cut around, so I'm going to click continue. And what it does is it creates this cutout, and then this is the image that will be printed. So you can save as print then cut, or you can just save the cut image. And I'm going to leave the name of the image, and I'm going to click save. Now there are a couple little spots here where there must have been pen marks, but I'm not going to worry about those. Okay. And it's thinking, and sometimes this takes a little while to work. And what I have found is when I go into the saved image and it's on my mat, here we go. Okay, so now what I want to do, here's my saved image. I am going to click new, and I am going to click images, which would be on the left hand toolbar of Design Space, and it's uploading images. Now I want to filter on the images that I've uploaded. Now I've uploaded quite a few, so it brings up a lot, and I'm thinking that my scroll, there we go, isn't working so well, so I'm gonna scroll to the bottom. Oh yeah, I've got a lot. Okay, so I should have put a filter name on here. Let's see. I just happened to remember the part of the name was BFD. So I filtered on what I had uploaded and then on the name of the image. Yeah, it was Dancing Leap by BFD. So here's my image. So I'm going to click, and I always double click and that doesn't give me what I need. I'm going to click until the green box is around it, and I'm going to click Insert Images. and it is bringing my image to my mat. Very slowly. My internet connection is not the best. But what I'll do is once I bring the image in, I will size it to the size that I want for my card, and I can go ahead and click make it and print my image, and it will print registration marks all the way around my image. And then I will take that image, I will decorate the image the way that I want to decorate it, and then I will bring it back, place it on my mat, and it will cut out the image that I want. Now my card is going to be 5.25 by 4.25. So I need my image to be rather small so it fits within that space. So I've resized it to approximately 5x4-ish. Now I'm going to click make it. And if you notice, and I'm also going to cut out two. And the reason that I do that is I want to layer, and I'm going to have to do some fussy cutting in order to layer, but that's okay. I think it'll be a pretty simple fussy cut. And I think when I do that fussy cutting, I can recover from the fact that this will be cut out. So here are the registration marks that go all the way around the image, and that's how it's going to print. So I'm going to click continue, and sorry, those are my dogs going crazy, and my dog here barking. Ugh. It's wild. Okay, and here I'm going to click send to printer.